Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at how we calculate expected frequency when we're dealing with probability. So expected frequency is the amount of times we would expect a specific outcome to occur over a set number of trials. And the way we would calculate our expected frequency is by taking the probability of an outcome occurring and then multiplying that probability by the total number of trials. So let's take a look at this example of flipping a fair two-sided coin. So when we flip a fair two-sided coin, the probability of the coin landing on heads is 1/2. And that means that the probability that the coin lands on tails will also be 1/2. So let's say we're going to flip this coin 500 times. So to figure out the expected frequency for heads, we'd simply take the probability of the coin landing on heads, which is 1/2, and then multiplying that by the total number of trials, which we've just said is 500. So if we do 1/2 multiplied by 500, that's going to give us 250. So we would expect this coin to land on heads 250 times. And then we do exactly the same for tails. We take the probability, which is 1/2, and then multiply that by the total number of trials, which again is 500. And that's going to give us the same result. We'd expect the coin to land on tails 250 times. Again, this is an expected frequency. It doesn't mean that this is going to happen exactly, but we would expect it to be somewhere relatively close. Okay, let's take a look at some practice questions. So for this first question, we have that the probability that a biased die will land on 4 is 0.2. The die is then going to be rolled 300 times. We need to work out an estimate for the number of times the die will land on 4. So to get our expected frequency that the die will land on 4, we're just going to take the probability that the die will land on 4, which we're told in the question is 0.2, and we're simply going to multiply that by the total number of times that the die is rolled, which is 300. So we need to do 0.2 multiplied by 300. So when we're multiplying with decimals, a simple trick we can do is multiply the numbers together as if there wasn't a decimal there. So I'm going to get rid of the decimal in that first number. So instead of 0.2, we're just going to have 0.2, which is 2. And there aren't any decimal places in the second number. So I'm just going to multiply that by 300. So 2 multiplied by 300 gives us 600. We can then use the digits in that answer to figure out the answer to the original question of 0.2 multiplied by 300. So all we need to do is count how many decimal places there are in each number. Well, there was one decimal place in our first number because we had 0.2. And for our second number, we've got a whole number. So we don't have any decimal places in this number. So all I do now is add these two numbers together. So 1 add 0 is going to give us 1. And that then shows us how many digits need to be to the right of the decimal place in our final answer. So going back to this 600, we're going to use them digits of 600. And we need to make sure that we put our decimal place back so that there is one digit on the right-hand side of the decimal point. Well, that is simply going to go here in between the two zeros. So our answer to the original question of 0.2 multiplied by 300 is 60.0. And that just simplifies to 60. So when the die is rolled 300 times, we can estimate that the die will land on 4 about 60 times. Okay, moving on, we have the probability that Daniel scores a penalty is 0.75. Daniel is going to take 60 penalties. Work out an estimate for the number of times Daniel will not score. So to get the expected frequency for the amount of times that Daniel will not score, we simply have to take the probability of him not scoring and then multiply that by the total number of penalties that he's going to take. So in the question, we've been given the probability of Daniel scoring a goal. And that is 0.75. So now we need to figure out the probability that he doesn't score. So there's only two outcomes for Daniel when he takes a penalty. He either scores or he doesn't score. So probabilities must always add up to 1. So to find the probability that he doesn't score, we're simply going to do 1 take away the probability that he does score. So we know that probability that Daniel scores is 0.75. So we're going to do 1 take away 0.75. So the probability that Daniel does not score is going to be 0.25. So we now take our probability of 0.25, and then we're going to multiply that by the total number of times that Daniel takes a penalty, which we're told in the question is 60. So we need to do 0.25 multiplied by 60. Well, we know 0.25 is the same as a quarter. So we're essentially doing a quarter of 60. Well, that is just 15. So out of the 60 penalties that Daniel takes, we expect him to miss 15 of them. Okay, for this next question, we have that a biased three-sided spinner is spun. The table shows the probability of the spinner landing on red and landing on blue. The spinner is then spun 200 times. We need to work out an estimate for the number of times that the spinner will land on green. So the first thing we need to do for this question is actually find the probability of the spinner landing on green. And the way we can do that is by adding up the probabilities that we already have, and then we can simply take that away from 1. Because all probabilities must always add up to 1. So we've got that the probability that the spinner lands on red is 2/5, and the probability that the spinner lands on blue is 3/10. So you want to add these fractions together. So when adding fractions, we want to make sure that we've got a common denominator. So for our common denominator, we want the lowest common multiple of 5 and 10. Well, that would actually be 10. We can leave blue as it is, and we can just find an equivalent fraction for our red. That is over 10. Well, to get from 5 to 10, we've simply multiplied by 2. So we're going to do exactly the same for the numerator. If we do 2 multiplied by 2, that's going to give us 4. So 2/5 is equivalent to 4/10, but that then is a lot easier to add with. So to start with, we're going to add our probabilities of red and blue. So we've got 4/10, add our 3/10. Well, that's simply going to give us 7/10. So then to find our probability of green, we're simply going to do 1, take away the sum of the other probabilities. So we're taking away 7/10. Well, again, when we're taking away fractions, we also want a common denominator. So we can simply write 1 as 10 over 10. So we're doing 10/10, take away 7/10. That's going to leave us with 3/10. So the probability of the spinner landing on green is 3/10. So then to work out the estimate for the number of times a spinner will land on green, we take the probability of the spinner landing on green, which is 3/10, and we're going to multiply that by the total number of times a spinner is spun, which it says in the question is 200. So now we've got 3/10 multiplied by 200. Well, when we've got a fraction multiplied by a whole number, we're just going to multiply the numerator by that 200. So that is the same as 600 over 10. We can then simplify that to 600 over 10, because 600 divided by 10 is just going to give us 60. So when the spinner is spun 200 times, we would expect the spinner to land on green 60 times. And for our final question, we have that the table shows the probabilities that a biased die will land on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. The die is rolled 500 times. Work out an estimate for the number of times the die will land on 3 or on 6. So the first thing we need to do here is figure out the probability that the die lands on 6. So again, to do that, we're going to add up all the probabilities that we've been given in the table so far. And when we do that, that should give us 0.76. And then all we need to do is take that away from 1, as all our probabilities should add up to 1. So if we do 1, take away our 0.76, that's going to give us 0.24. So that would be our probability that the die lands on 6. So then the question says, work out the estimate for the number of times the die will land on 3. Or on 6. Well, we know that the probability that the die lands on 3 is 0.05. And we've just figured out that the probability that the die will land on 6 is 0.24. So the probability that the die will land on 3 or on 6 is just going to be the sum of these two probabilities. So all we need to do is take our 0.05 and add it to this 0.24, and that's going to give us 0.29. So we now know that the probability that the die will land on a 3 or on a 6 is 0.29. So then to find the expected frequency that the die will land on a 3 or a 6, all we're going to do is take this probability of 0.29 and multiply it by the total number of times that the die is going to be rolled, which is 500. So then if we do 0.29 multiplied by 500, that's going to give us 145. So when the die is rolled 500 times, we would expect that the die lands on a 3 or on a 6, approximately 145 times. So well done if you followed along with those examples. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on working with probability, then I've left some links for them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.